play first. No mulligans, I suppose, although I can't say I love it. One thing I know that's been discussed is whether 25 or 26 is the right land count. I'm starting to join the 26 camp, although we did mulligan one 5 land 2 spell hand, so we've been hurt by both Flood and Screw a bit, but I feel like last game we needed a land to win and bricked. I feel like more often than not I'm wanting a land. I really would like to draw some Supreme Verdicts in this matchup. I think they would do a lot of work. Alright, there's a land, that's good. It's funny that this hand literally curves out 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not every day you see that. The classic Resto into Thragtusk curve is always a frustrating one, because you wish you could save the Resto, but almost never is it the correct play to save the Resto. If you have the luxury of saving it, it probably means you're winning anyway, especially when your deck has Prime Speaker in it as a follow-up. Well, that's not good. One more land unlocks Resto, Resto, and Revelate for one. So all we need. Alright, Reckoner. It's not a bad play. Alright, that's kind of like a land. I'm happy to trade Reckoner for Smiter here if he attacks, but I'm not going to be the one to instigate because I don't really want to trade damage. I just want the game to go as long as possible. So if we rip a land, we can slam Thragtusk. If not, I think it has to be better to play Resto than Revelate for one. I think it's important to do something productive every turn of the game. Thundermaw Hellkite. Alright, well there's a target for Charm. I was pretty sure he had that, or at least suspected it, but I don't know, maybe I should have played to it. It's hard to say. Alright, well this isn't great for the home team. If we had a land there, we could just slam Thragtusk and then gain 5 every turn. But without one, it might be tough to win. It's going to hit us for 5 here, down to 8. This follow-up better be real weak. Does that mean Resto? Resto would be miserable for us because it would tap this one. Yeah, Resto would just be game over, as a matter of fact. Just cannot beat it, and I feel pretty confident that he has it, unfortunately. Alright, so that makes things a little bit interesting. So if I play Thragtusk, I go to 13. Yeah, it feels like the right play. Thragtusk go. Yeah, seems right to me. I could attack on the grounds that if he has Resto, I'm dead anyway, but I don't know, that doesn't seem right. I might as well try to beat Resto. So yeah, there it is. That's 8 damage on board, so we can survive barring, you know, one of a thousand things. Aurelia, another Thundermaw, Hellrider. Hellrider wouldn't kill us, I suppose. Aurelia, second Thundermaw, definitely would. Maybe that's it. Maybe it's actually not that easy for him to kill us from here. And our next turn is actually pretty good. Who knows? Maybe we have a puncher's chance. Huntmaster. How does that affect things? Well, the only really obvious conclusion is that we do not want to pass the turn anymore. So I guess I just rest on my Thrag Tusk and pass and hope that he doesn't have another Thunder Maw or Resto. If he had another Thunder Maw, he would have killed us. If he had another Resto, saving it would make sense. So that's the bigger concern. Although it is worth noting another Resto would put us to one. It wouldn't kill us. So there is that. Well, we're putting up a bit of a fight here. The Naya deck is so threat dense, it's very difficult to play against. Just every card in their deck feels like it requires an answer. But a sweeper would still be... Yeah, if we drew Verdict at any point, I think I would consider us a favorite. But of course, we might just be dead here, so... And that's moot. Oh, he did have the Resto? Yeah. Alright, so... We could be going as low as 1 in this combat step. Although, I don't really think he's going to attack with anything except those two. Even if I wanted to try to pass the turn to play around another Resto out of him, I can't afford to. Just because I'll die to the Huntmaster ability. So I'm definitely going to main phase Resto here. Resto over playing Thrag Tusk because it just applies more stuff to the board and more flying blockers, which could be relevant. I could have attacked there, but I didn't really see much of a point. First of all, he would probably block, and second of all, even if he didn't... the life totals could be relevant, although not very, he's at 22. And it was more just that I thought he would have like a pretty simple block of just like Wolf plus Pilgrim. Alright, so he didn't have any tricks up his sleeve. The problem is that doesn't mean we're out of the woods. So... The only block that lets us survive is one on each. With us at 7, so that's the block I'm going to make. If he tramples over here, he can put us to 1. Oh, and then flip Huntmaster. So yeah, if he does that, I suppose... we can upkeep Revelation with the Huntmaster trigger on the stack, but... We have no long-term outs. So if he makes that play, we can just pack it in. If he instead pumps all the way on a Resto, he gets... only 4 trample puts us to 3. Huntmaster flips puts us to 1, and then Verdict would be, you know, a not unreasonable draw. The moment of truth, what is he targeting? So he did go with Resto. Okay, so better than the alternative. I imagine that means he has something with haste in his hand. But, can't say for sure. Those missed land drops are really what's going to do us in here. Yep, that'll do it. Well, some pretty bad draws on our part. I'm going to finish out the daily since I want to see what this deck can do a little bit more. I feel like our draws, didn't really give us a chance in any of these games, but that's not necessarily a bad indication on the deck. So I'll play the last two rounds. All right, I'll be back.